In this video, you will learn how to use theme colors in Microsoft Word, which will enable you to change the whole color styling of your document within seconds. And by the way, these resume templates that you're seeing here are templates that I created and that are completely free, so check them out if you want to update your current resume. Now, what are theme colors? Theme colors are basically a set of colors which can be implemented into your Word document. And then every part of your document will be using these colors. Of course, you will have to build up your document correctly, but we will look into the correct use later on. So, which parts of the document do the theme colors affect and how? The parts in which you will spot the theme colors the easiest are the headings and the shapes, and of course also the color palette. So, whenever you see a color selector, no matter if it's for the font color, the paragraph background color, a table border color, and so on, Word will always offer you the template colors. Now, how do we change them? We can change the colors in the Design tab. And here, we will have the option to change the whole document theme. But this would not only change the colors, but also the fonts, the effects, the spacings, and so on. Fortunately, we also have the options to change only the theme colors. When we click on the Colors button, we have all the custom color palettes at the top and then the predefined Microsoft Office color palettes below. When we hover over these palettes, Word will show us a live preview. And as you can see, this allows us to change the whole color style within seconds. But it can also be the case that you're designing some documents for your own company and then you would want to have the colors from your corporate design in the theme colors. And this is what we can do when we click on Customize Colors. Here, you first of all set your main text color and your main background color. If your corporate design also includes a second text color with a second background color, then you can add these colors below. And the accent color is now where all the magic happens, because accent 1 is by default being used by the heading styles, the shapes, and so on. So make sure that your main accent color is placed in spot number 1. And then you proceed entering all your other corporate colors. If you still have spots left, because maybe you don't need accent 4, 5, and 6, then you can simply make them black or white so that they don't distract you. And the hyperlink colors are probably self-explaining. Now that you've set up the whole color palette, you of course also need to know how to use it. Basically, the main rule that you have to follow is that you always use these colors that you've just defined whenever you open a color selector. So let me show this to you. From now on, when you click on a color selector, you don't use the standard colors, you also don't use the More Colors option. You only use the colors from the defined palette. And it would also be good that you use the available font styles, since they automatically contain your new color set. If you don't know how to use font styles, check out my other videos. I've also created a video for theme fonts. So if you want to have the same flexibility for your fonts, check out that video. Thanks for watching, and remember, if this video was helpful for you, please return me the favor by giving me a thumbs up. See you in the next one.